الله وبركاته. My name is Khalid Abu Shafi'. Great to have you with us in this Tajweed presentation and the podcast. And we are still in the letters of Al-Makhraj Al-Halq. And we have said that among the Makhraj Al-Halq is divided into 3 points of articulations. Number one, the Adna Al-Halq, which is close to the mouth, and Aqsa al-Halq, and that is the farthest distance from the mouth, and the middle part is called Wasat al-Halq. The middle part, it has Ayn, that we have seen last presentation of video 5, and in this presentation we are going to talk about the second letter of the middle part of the throat, al-Halq, the point of articulation of the Ha. And the Ha, it is slightly have some air flowing when pronouncing the letter Ha, especially if it's with the sukun, as you can say so the air is flowing. That's it's called the quality and the attribute of Hams, and we are going inshallah to see the qualities and the attributes of Tajweed later on inshallah. The common mistakes in pronouncing the letter Ha, number one, the letter Ha, it needs that Baha. The Baha in Arabic language is that the sounding of so it has to be filled. It's not Ha, it's not A, it's Ha, Ha. And it's not Ha either. So Ha, it is a letter that is muraqqaq, which is an empty mouth. In a similarly, it has some air flowing. And whenever it comes in the Quran with a sukoon, you have to observe the way how you pronounce it. For example, if I say the example, the second example in the middle part, this example, yuhyi. So what happens when I say you, the mouth and the lips are directed towards the front, forwarded, and it makes the shape of Dhamma. Now, the common mistake is not to bring it back. So what happens, you say you, yuhyi, and you say the ha with the sukun while the lips are forwarded, which is wrong. So what happens, you say the you, the ya with the dhamma, you, and then it's in the same time you bring it back into the position of the sukun as you say ah, without making that forward of the dhamma. So the shape of the dhamma has to disappear when saying the ha. Similarly, al-muhsinin, so it has dhamma, al-muhsinin يحيي فأحياكم الرحمن. And the common also mistake when saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, so say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Bismillah ar-Rah, slightly have that flowing of the air, it's called al-Hams, to be given time. This is according to the speed of reading, of course. I'm not saying to pause, but to give slightly that air and time in pronouncing the letter Ha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. And also the last example, Uhshuru. Similarly, when you say U, by saying U, the Ha will be in a position of the Dhamma. So you have to be careful, bring your lips back into the Sukoon as you say Ah instead of Uh. Uhshuru alladhina, and so on. So in this presentation, it's the letter Ghain, as I have said at the beginning of the in this presentation, number 6, I have said that we have seen Ghain and Kha. Actually, we haven't seen Ghain and Kha. We have seen Ayn, and we have seen the Hamza and the Ha. But Ghain and Kha, we're going to see them, inshallah, in this presentation. So the letter Ghain, it's a letter that is Mufakham. Mufakham means full mouth, a little bit heavy, slightly heavy. So it is not like the Ha. The Ha and the Ayn are empty mouth. The Hamza is empty mouth. The Ha is empty mouth. The Ghain and the Kha are full mouth. So you say Kha, Gha. You don't say Gha, and you don't say Kha. So if your name is Khalid, you would say Kha, and you don't say Khalid. Khalid. Alright. So when we have the letter Ghain, just to be careful, if it has a sukun, not to make the qalqala. That's number one. And the second, not to make the ghunna, And the third, not to make change it into another letter such as Qaf. So for example, if I have when I read Surah Al-Fatiha, in this example, غير المغضوب. So what happened? The common mistakes is people make qalqala. So we say غير المغضوب, غير المغضوب, and that is wrong. And the quality and the attribute of the ghain is to spend slightly the tongue in the sound. By spending slightly the sound, the qalqala will disappear. Just understand this. The letters of qalqala are five. We're going to see them, inshallah. So you say letters collected in five characters, five letters in Arabic language. قطب جدٍ قاف طاء باء جيم دال. Every time they come with the sukun in the middle of the word or the end of the word, they sounding like an echoing. So that echoing exists in these letters of قاف طاء باء جيم دال. But غين doesn't have that قلقلة. So you would say, for example, الذي أطعمهم اقترب قاف وما أدراك دال أدراك. That is قلقلة. But غين doesn't have قلقلة. To avoid the قلقلة is to spend some time, and you say غير المغضوب مغضوب, instead of saying غير المغضوب مغضوب, and that is wrong. The second thing, do not change the letter غين into قاف غير المغضوب. Some countries, and actually we have parts in North Africa, specifically in my country, we have some regions in the southeast where they change the ghain into qaf. There are a lot of Arabs do that. It's probably has an origin in linguistic and linguistic origin in Arabic language and Arabic dialects of the Arabs. Some people in the Sudan also do that. So they say qayri. But of course, the people who are Qurra and the people who are reciting Quran wouldn't do that, but the common people would say it in a common language, in a common speech, in their talking and conversations. So when you say al-maghdubi, do not make it as qaf, qayri al-maghdubi, but say ghayri al-maghdubi, al-maghdubi. And to be careful also not to make the letter after the ghain mufakham. Now, look at this example on the left side. Bima gha, it's mufakham, which is full mouth. Fa is muraqqaq, which is empty mouth. Ra, it is mufakham. So you would be saying bima ghafara, 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 instead of saying ghafa, ghafara, bima ghafara. غفر لي ربي بما غفر لي ربي. And not to make it all ترقيق. بما غفر لي غفر. That is wrong also. So sometimes the full mouth letter can drag some of the letters which are neighbors next to it and drag it into the same state of attribute. And the other thing to have a look at the front at the beginning, the first one, the dua in Surah Al-Imran, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا. Do not make idgham there. So do not join them as one letter. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْقُ لَا تُزِغْقُ لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا. That is idgham. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا. Do not make that pause in between the two letters either. And do not make the idgham in the two letters. But just to drag your attention, the ghain here, as it is the ulama mentioned, that slightly make it la tuzir muraq, tafkhim nisbi. And we're going to see this in tafkhim and tarqiq and isti'la and istifal. I don't want to go too much into it, but just to make it slightly empty mouth, and I tell you the reason later on, inshallah, when we get to the attribute. So you say, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا, instead, لَا تُزِغْ. But there is some of the ulama who are in the Middle East, in Syria, they do make, and this is has a little bit of details which I'm going to talk later on about the five different details and three different details about tafkhim and tarqiq in some of the letters they call tafkhim nisbi. So let's see these examples, and these examples, as we can see, the letter Kha. The letter Kha is similar to the letter Ghain. It has tafkhim and it has full mouth. And this full mouth means do not neglect it. So when we say, for example, wa idh akhadha Allahu, do not say wa idh akhadha Allahu. And remember, do not use your lips when saying Gha or Kha. Lips, nothing to do. This is the makhraj. The point of articulation is the throat, it's not the lips. You find some people try to make it sound like real kha by saying kholaqa kha, and they put their lips and their mouth forward to pronounce kha, but there's nothing such thing. All you do, open your mouth slightly up vertically and make that sounding normal as you say kha instead of kho, kho, by putting your lips forward. It's kha, gha. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ. Similarly, اتَّخَذُوا. This example, اتَّخَذُوا. So you don't say اتَّخَذُوا. And also, Imam al-Jazari mentioned this example, مَخْمَصَةٍ, مَخْمَصَةٍ, instead of مَخْمَ, مَخْمَ. So the ميم مرقق, ميم is empty mouth, another ميم is an empty mouth, and خا is in between a full mouth, مَخْمَصَةٍ. Similarly, the صاد also is a full mouth. This example of in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, مَخْضُود. So the ميم has to remain empty mouth, but the خا and the ضاد is full mouth. مَخْضُود. And the dal remains also muraqqaq, empty mouth. The last example is to be careful not to make the lam as full mouth. And the reason, kha is mufakham and lam is muraqqaq, which is empty mouth. The ta is full mouth. So how do we read? Khalatu, khalatu, khalatu. So, Jazakumullahu khairan for listening. Inshallah, I see you in the Read With Me. I may produce, inshallah, within this week, the episode number 4 and 5, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me tawfiq. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hani'an mari'an walidaka alayhima malabisu anwarin min at-taji wal